Hey everyone, it is Yasmine Woodland and welcome back to my channel. First and foremost, I want to thank you guys so much for all the love, all the support. I want to thank everyone for signing the petition for hashtag justice for Nugget. I want to thank everyone for subscribing and viewing my content and just being a part of this channel. I absolutely adore each and every one of you. I am open to all your thoughts and I read all your comments. So I thank you guys so much for being a part of this and supporting my channel and supporting the loss of Nugget as well. So getting into the story, you guys, okay? So I'm getting into the juicy news, right? So as you can tell by the title of this video, it is alleged that David Eason got thrown out of the supervised visitation with his kids after losing his temper, you guys, okay? So I'm gonna insert a little snippet for you guys to see so you can read along with me. David Eason and Jenelle Evans reportedly had their first supervised visitation yesterday, and by all accounts, it did not go as expected. Eason supposedly lost his temper, which is said to have resulted in him being thrown out of the visitation. Jenelle reportedly stayed to continue the visitation with Inslee, Jace, and Marissa. Kaiser, who is said to be staying with his biological father, Nathan Griffith, was not present, according to the reports. Inslee and Marissa were there. They're staying with Marissa's grandmother. An insider told Radar Online about the visit. David was thrown out because he was arguing with the social workers, the source continues. He was causing trouble. He was arguing with everybody. The Jenelle did not appear to be upset during the meeting. She's reportedly set to appear in court today to fight CPS to get their kids back. The supervised visitation comes after CPS removed all of the children from their home over the past couple of days. Kaiser was removed last Friday, and Inslee and Marissa were removed this week. The move came after David Eason shot and killed Jenelle's dog, Nugget, after it nipped at Inslee, with the incident caught on video. Investigators are said to be looking into the shooting death of Nugget. Right now, no charges have been laid against Eason, but it is possible he could face legal trouble. Teen Mom 2 is done for the season. The new season is expected to air later this year without Jenelle Evans. Now this news, you guys, happened about 2 days ago. So today is Saturday. So this happened Thursday, this entire visitation incident. So I am extremely appalled at the situation. I did not expect David to act like that during his visitation with his children. It's not just this one news outlet, it's numerous sources from everywhere stating that he lost his temper during the visitation. And even some of you guys have commented below saying, well, I heard that David lost his temper. Like, what is the info? What is the information on that? So here's a story about that, you guys. Apparently he was just so upset about the entire CPS investigation, CPS situation, to where his kids, or I'm not gonna say his kids, he really only looks at Inslee, you know, that is his biological child, and Marissa. So about his two children just being taken out of the home because of his actions, and he's angry about that. So getting into my final thoughts on this situation, you guys, I'm not gonna make this video too long-winded. I don't really know, you know, how Jenelle feels in this situation, or if she even has a say-so in this situation, but I just think that David's behavior disgusts me. If he's a CPS, if he's, you know, doing his visitations and, you know, there's caseworkers there and CPS workers there, my question is, why is he angry at them? They didn't beat up a dog. They didn't shoot a dog. They didn't do any of that. This is his actions. You know, this is the complete definition of someone who is just a narcissist, maybe. I mean, he caused this entire incident. He caused his children to get taken away, but yet he's taking out all his frustration and anger on the CPS workers when they're just doing their job. You know, they were just looking out for the best interests of the kids. Now, a lot of you guys have been saying, well, CPS isn't any different, putting them in foster care. Those claims are completely false. I don't know if someone had commented in my video or and said that they were placed in foster care, and I'm just like, no, that's completely false. The children, as per the sources, they are placed with their grandmother. So that foster care, that's completely false. But back to David, I have no idea why he's taking this out on everyone else but himself. And like, if you like look at the pictures, you know, with him and Jenelle, like he just looks like, I don't know, he looks like he's truly a narcissist. Like he doesn't even look at himself as to blame. He's literally blaming everyone else around him, and it's just so sad. Like he wants to play victim maybe in this situation, and it's just like, how can you even do this? You know, your actions got your kids taken away, and Jenelle standing by him got her kids taken away as well. She could have easily ran for the hills, you guys. She could have easily, I'm not gonna say easily, because you know, being in a relationship when there's abuse going on is never easy. However, if you truly want to get out for the sake of your kids and yourself, there's so many outlets, there's so many people there to help you, you know. So Jenelle could have gotten help, but she chose to stay by David, and now all of her kids are gone. As you guys have been commenting, you know, her livelihood is gone, her money, her kids is all gone. So the fact that he lost his temper during a visitation just goes to show that he doesn't even need supervised visitations. He really does not need that right now. So I wonder how this will play out. I wonder if the judge will hear of this, or if they have another court hearing about this situation. I don't know. I'm just gonna see how it plays out. But I really think that his behavior is just disgusting, and Jenelle is really no better, man. Like I used to really like think that she is a victim in regards to domestic violence, period. I know you guys are saying she's not a victim. She's not a victim in the case of the dog killing, yes, but in my opinion, she's a victim of domestic abuse, because no one on this earth deserves to be beaten up. That's just it, or just, you know, have hands put on them against their will. And I know a couple of you guys have commented your stories of domestic violence and you know overcoming domestic abuse. So you guys know how these things goes. So you guys were victims in that case. So in this case of Jenelle and David, she's a victim to the domestic abuse, period. But she's not a victim in this dog killing situation. I think that she could have just broken away from David, and she could have took her kids and sought help. But she chose to stand by David, and now all of her kids are taken out of the home and her money's gone. So I'm gonna stop rambling, you guys. I'm gonna let you guys comment your thoughts on what you think about this entire situation of David Eason losing his temper during the visitation with his children. What do you guys think about this situation? Comment below your thoughts. Make sure you subscribe and tap the bell to get notifications on future videos that I upload. Thank you guys for all the love and support. Thank you guys for tuning in. And until I see you guys next time, see you.